In December last year, the State Minister of Land, Sam Mayanja, convened a meeting in Kakunyu Namusera in Wakiso District to hear complaints of land grabbing. During the meeting, hundreds of people accused one Dr. Apollo Kagwa of a number of atrocities, including demolishing their houses and forcefully grabbing their land, which they had occupied for decades. Majority of the complainants were reportedly Bibanja holders on the contested land. In the same meeting, the same matter has since been brought to the floor of Parliament by MP Medard Seguna. Urban TV followed up on the matter in an interview with Dr. Kagwa, who insists he is the rightful owner of the land in question.
There was one directive of 16th of December. At that time, I was trying to take my first letter to the minister to make him understand that he was duped by land grabbers to make such a serious decision against me. And as we were in the reception there, then I saw our land grabbers from Wakiso comfortably waiting for the minister. I checked in the visitor's book. They were all going to see Mr. Mayanja. But okay, Dr. Mayanja. That's when I realized that these land grabbers are very smart these days.
He argues that nowadays land grabbers have developed a new technique where they hire people to claim to be victims of land evictions. He wants the laws on land reviewed to protect the landlords and their tenants, explaining that with the recent spate of land conflicts in the country, national development is at stake.
Because the matter has been taken to the House of Parliament, we are hoping that, whereas police was already investigating the matter, our political leaders through Parliament are also going to investigate the matter a little deeper, and they will get us information which should clarify even more than I'm doing now to clarify the matter to the public. I'm sure there are many other people who may benefit from a good outcome of this investigation, because the land issues have, if it was a medical thing, have reached an epidemic proportion. They've reached an epidemic proportion, and the sooner a solution is found, the better.
Ezra Nyarua, a land lawyer, reveals that one of the biggest drivers of land conflicts are politicians who seem to go by the numbers rather than getting to the real issue.
Being out that politicians go with numbers, whether they are wrong or they are right, that one is known. So Dr. Kagwa is one and he owns the property. People may not listen to him. They may listen to people who claim Bibanja, even when they don't have anything to prove. Because to own a chivanja, you should know your landlord. You should have bought it legally, and you should be paying busuru. If he had made time to verify all that, maybe you'd not have taken such a decision. And maybe we expect, after getting the information, maybe they will change their decision. But of course, we expect them to stop because their case is going on. And what they are doing is contempt. Because if there is an appeal going on, you make a directive to order the alleged Bibanja owners to go and possess land. What happens to the case? In any case, why do you have a case in court? What are they going to determine if status quo is being changed?